All right, so now that you've turned in your brainstorming and you have a photo that you would like. So I Googled myself, and this is the photo that's in Google for our school and our school website. So this is me, and I did my face mapping, like in the video that you saw Coach Clark gave you, where he told you to do your highlights and then do your dark darks and then your middle tones. So I put an L on mine. So after you finish mapping yourself out, you are going to take your picture and you are going to flip it over to the back. You are going to put pencil all over the back of your picture, just all over the back like that, a nice thick layer of pencil through the whole page. When you get your whole page done, you'll see the Sharpie or the marker that you use to outline yourself. Now, when you get that done, you're going to flip it over, put it on your paper, and you're going to trace your whole face mapping. So you trace this, you trace that, you trace a highlight of the nose, you trace any shadows, you trace the shape of your lips, your eyes, you trace everything that you can on here. When you lift it up, and you're tracing it onto your chipboard, I'm sorry, your chipboard. When you lift it up, you have an image of yourself that has your highlights and all your images mapped out for you so that you know where your dark objects go, where your light objects go, and just pretty much it's a good image of yourself. I hope you can see that okay on camera like I can in person. But here's a face map of you. The next thing you have to do is decide if you're going to lay down some color. I decided that I wanted to use some crayon for my dark areas, and I grabbed a violet for my hair because it's kind of dark compared to the rest of me. And I'm going to go ahead and just put this violet, and then I decided to go with buttons for my hair because I had a bunch of buttons at home. So that's what I'm going to put there. The reason I put the crayon underneath there is because I don't want the chipboard to show through. I want color to show underneath when I glue these down. So that brings me to supplies. Look, what you have in your kit is glue, a piece of chipboard, and some origami paper. That's all you have. The rest of it is just trash, things that you randomly find. So I literally found these two pieces of ripped up tissue paper in my room, and I kept them. Some stuff came in the mail packing, so I kept these, the packing paper, they're the little bubbles. I kept the bubble wrap. I found this thing. It's just some plastic. I don't know what it is. Like I told you, I had a bunch of buttons. So I have buttons. I got a paper towel, and then I found all these toothpicks. So this is just random stuff that I found. Now, it would be a really good idea if you look at combination of your photo and your drawing when you start deciding. And look, this is my darkest darkest. So if I wanted to put a number five on my hair, I would put a number five. My eyebrows would be a number five, and my pupils would be a number five. So those are my darkest. If you look here in the shadow of my face, that's like number four. And then number three would be here. Number two is the middle of my face. And number one is the super highlights. So that's how you think about value and what's darkest, darkest, and what's lightest, lightest. And remember, my art element that I'm focusing on is going to be value. So I really want to look at my values, what's darker, what's lightest. When I look at all these materials, and when I decide what should, oh yeah, I also found a bunch of feathers. When I decide what to use, sometimes when you have everything in color and you have a photo that's in black and white, it's really hard to see and decide what should I make, which piece. So you can go crazy with color if you want, but if you really want it to look real and kind of cool, like the examples we saw, then I like to grab my cell phone, and take a picture of the materials. Just take a picture of it. Then put the black and white filter on it. Change it to a black and white photo, and it's going to show me what's actually dark and what's actually light. And it's going to help me decide what I put in the darks and what I put in the lights. It's just a little visual trick so that you can see all the color and you can see which is actually dark and light compared to each other. So, after you decide what's dark and light and what you're going to put everywhere, obviously, then you have your chipboard. The next step is to decide to lay down color. You can lay down paint. You can lay down crayon or markers if you want to. You don't have to. You can do that. Then you start gluing all your pieces down. Start gluing your buttons where you want them. Start gluing just everything you want wherever you want it. Make your little pattern in the back with the toothpicks, whatever you want. Make it, glue it. If you want to paint that stuff on top, you can. So here are your choices. Paint and color first, then glue, then paint again, whatever sections you want. Like if I were to use this, I wouldn't want it to see through color. I would probably paint it on top. You can just paint first and color first and then glue and stop. You can not paint if you don't want to. Glue everything down and then paint in the end. So it's a lot of choices, and it's just about having fun and making a mixed media portrait of yourself. So I hope that answers your questions. If you have any more, please, please, please go ahead and email me or put it in the inbox in Canvas. I'm about to end the video, but I've got to lower it so I can reach the phone. All right, guys. Sorry, that was kind of quick. Well, actually, it's good because maybe now you can see my drawing. You see how it's face mapped? It's in sections. Is that zooming in okay? All right. Thank you, guys.